So hi, Yanni, welcome back to Italy.
Hello, and thank you for having me again.
How are you doing?
All good. Like, it's been a traveling day, so had to wake up pretty early, but now I got some rest and getting ready to rock out.
So let's talk about your new project, The Dark Element, which is actually coming out today. Can you give us some background information about it, how you were approached by the label and how it all came to be?
Yeah, like 2016 spring, I was actually touring with Timo in Northern Finland, and I got an email from Frontiers, and they asked for one song for this other project. And I told them that I'm really busy, but I'll try to do it, and got back home and had 2 days to write it. And I wrote one song and sent it to them, and it got accepted on the album. And then maybe a week later, Serafino from Frontiers wrote to me and asked, like, would you like to write and produce an album? Like, let's find you a singer. And I had some free time at that point, so I was, sure, this sounds like fun. And then they asked who I'd want to work with, and I had no idea. I just told them that I would like to really work with a woman this time, since I've been lucky enough to work with, like, Timo Kotipelto and Toni Kakko and all great male singers. I'd never worked with women before, so okay, let's find you a woman. Then that's not bad, but but yeah, then it took like 3 days, and they got back to me and said, like, Anette Olsson. And I was like, yes, of course. Like, I would not have thought about that myself, but that's perfect. Like, and then we just started working together on the album, and now today it comes out, and 1.5 years of hard work comes into fruition.
And what was the most difficult challenge you faced producing this album?
There was nothing really difficult. It was surprisingly easy, actually. Of course, since me and Anette were not physically in the same place, so she had to go and sing in another studio and then send me the tracks, and then I'll go through them and put everything in place. So that was kind of difficult at some time, since usually when I record with a singer, I'm at the same place. I'm in the studio actually recording the singer. So if there's something that's not right, like rhythm is wrong, or there's some issues in the melody, I can say it immediately, like, that this is wrong, like, it goes like this. But this time I had to wait for her versions to come and then listen to it and then send, like, email back. But otherwise good, but this part has to be done differently, and then try to explain it on an email, what's wrong with it. That's difficult.
And as you said, it's the first time you work with a female singer. So was it more difficult than working with male singers, or?
No, it was pretty much exactly the same, like, as for working with Timo, for instance. Like, they are professional singers and they know what they are doing. It's very easy.
How did you come up with the name The Dark Element, and what or who is The Dark Element in the band?
Actually, The Dark Element was, at first, it was just name of one song. But then I thought, like, that's pretty cool title. So then it became the title of the album. And then somehow it became the title of the project as well. I don't know what happened there. But yeah, well, I don't really want to start talking about what The Dark Element is. It's kind of self-explanatory if you listen to the actual song. Like, it's the little thing we all have inside us. And I don't know who's the dark element in our band. Probably me, the darkest of them all.
So you also produced the album. What kind of record did you want to create? Did you achieve what you were expecting?
Yeah, I actually did achieve what I was trying to do. When I started working on it, I didn't really have a clear idea at first, like, what should I do? But then I decided that I'm going to steer away from doing material that would be like Kane's Offering, just Anette singing. Like, that makes no sense. Why would I have two projects that sound exactly the same, only the singer is different? So I decided that I'm going to try and make it more straightforward and into the point, like, make the songs a bit more simple than they are, for instance, with Kane's Offering, and make it just as catchy and, like, well, catchy is probably the best word. Like, make catchy, I don't want to say simple songs, because they're not simple per se, but they're not just as complicated as what I usually write.
Most of the songs are a great mix of heavy and melodic music with catchy hooks. But one of them, the most different among them, is the ballad Heaven of Your Heart. Could you tell us something about its genesis?
That was actually just this piano riff that I had for a while, and I wanted to write like this ballad that has no drums and it stays pretty soft all the way through. Well, it builds up in the end a little, but it doesn't explode like ballads usually do. Oh, there's no real story there. I just had this idea and then I started working on it, and it took quite a lot of work to make it actually work, since that kind of writing is not my strongest suit. But then when I got it done and sent it to Annette, then she liked it a lot, and then when she sent me her version of it with her vocals, I was like, shit, this works. Like, now it works.
Okay. On the other hand, Dead to Me is a very fast and heavy song, and it would be great to see you performing live on stage. Have you already started planning a tour for to support this release?
Well, we're not planning a tour per se, but we are talking about live shows. Yes, we have some offers already, and some festivals, one tour offer actually as well. But we need to discuss all the logistics and timing and finances and everything like this, so it's a difficult process. But it seems like everyone would really want to try and play this stuff out live, so let's hope we can make it happen. I was actually supposed to have a meeting today with our representative, but he just sent me an email that he can't make it tonight, so let's talk in Skype when I get back to Finland. So. But we're trying.
Mm-hmm. Great. Well, let's talk about Black Acoustic now. Have you already discussed the possibility of a new Black Acoustic album?
Yeah, we've talked about it a lot, or not a lot, but like many times, many different times in history. And also the label has approached us about it like already a year or two ago. But we may do it, but the difficult thing is that Timo has Stratovarius, I have Kim Suffering, and also have now Dark Element, and then I've been working with Insomnium and all this stuff. So us two finding the time to record an album together is not an easy task. And also we have some ideas of how it should be done this time, since we don't want to make the exact same format of just us playing cover songs. So we have different ideas, but I don't want to discuss them yet.
Okay, have you ever dreamt or considered playing in Stratovarius?
Oh, yeah, actually I have, when I was like a little kid. Like when I was 16, 17, when I started listening to Stratovarius. But I don't think I ever, at that point, I was just a kid practicing guitar, so I don't think I even could think that big that I would want to play in Stratovarius. And it's funny, since it was at one point one of my favorite bands, and I was listening to a lot of them. And then, funny how life works out, like... Yes. Now I'm working with Timo, and I've also been working with Stratovarius and writing and recording for them. So if only the little Jani back then knew how it was going to go.
What other musicians would you like to work with?
Oh, God, this is a difficult question. Like, oh, who would I want to work with? Well, maybe Devin Townsend. Like, I admire him a lot. He would probably be my first pick.
Yeah, great choice.
And now the question that I think most Sonata Arctica fans would like to ask you. Would you ever consider going back to Sonata Arctica if Tony asked you, like, tomorrow to go back?
I don't know if I could do it, since I'm so busy now with other stuff. Of course, like, I'm totally open to playing with them again, like... doing one show where I'm part of it. Of course, Elias would have to be a part of it as well, since we're not going to replace him. That makes no difference. No, it makes difference and it makes no sense. And also, I think by this time, Elias has probably been in the band longer than I was, or at least very close. So he would have to be there too. But of course, it might be fun at some point to play with them, to do something. Or if Elias was to be hurt, God forbid, no. And they would need a tour guitar player. And if I had time, and they would ask, yeah, of course I would do it. They're my friends still. But joining them again, I don't see it happening just because of what I do nowadays. Yeah. since I remember being in Sonata Arctica, and it takes amazing amount of time to be in that band since it's a hardworking band and they tour a lot. And I also have a lot of other stuff I need to take care of, so I don't think it would be a feasible option.
Okay, well, that was the last question. So thank you for your time. And would you like to leave a message to our followers, your Italian fans? The camera is on.
Hello, all the good people here in Italy. It's been awesome every time I've been here, and it seems to be continuing going awesome. You are amazing. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much, Yanni.